Step 4. Customizing how your website looks. At this point, your website should look something similar to this. The designs may be different, depending on which free design WordPress are offering pre-installed at the time. 1. Finding a design for your website. By using WordPress, you are now able to use over 100,000 already created blog designs. Some free and some much better that come at a small cost. I recommend you go to Themeforest and look through their theme library of over 30,000 designs. Once you have chosen and downloaded your blog theme, you need to log into your WordPress admin area. Then click Appearance on the left side, then click Themes. Click Upload, find your theme. And once installed, activate. For my wedding blog, I used Current's theme. This is what it now looks like. 2. How to customize your blog design. With most good blog themes, you get a custom dashboard to edit the look and feel of the theme. On the left-hand side of your WordPress admin area, click the blue button with the name of your theme on it. In here you can edit almost everything, it's all very self-explanatory, go through it and make the changes you want. Next, click on Appearance. Widgets on the sidebar. Here you can move things around, adding, editing and removing widgets on your blog. A widget is like a gadget or an attachment. Something not required for the site to function but can be used to improve it in some way. An example of a widget could be an advert, an email sign-up box or popular posts. Here's how my blog looks now. Here's an example of what your website could look like immediately after following this guide. This is a typically look I go for when I create every new blog, including income diary. I keep it simple, I make it usable. Then once the site proves itself, I invest more money and time into it. This way, I risk a little up front, but using a few great resources, still manage to build a professional looking site. Step 5, optimizing your website for search engines. The majority of our website traffic comes from Google. To rank high in Google, you need to work on your website's search engine optimization. It's best to get this step right from the very beginning because it will save you a lot of time in the future. Not to mention you will get a lot more traffic sooner. Here's a list of our top SEO tips for new websites. Install Yoast SEO plugin for WordPress. Choose your permalink settings. I recommend %postname%- this will mean your blog posts URLs will display as domain.com web link. A lot of bloggers include category or date in permalink, but this is not something I would recommend because it makes it difficult to change categories or dates as it will change the URL. Research keywords using ARIFs. Keywords are the search terms you want to rank for in Google. ARIFs tells you which keywords get what amount of traffic. Make sure to add links in posts to other pages on your site and other people's sites in posts. This helps Google figure out what your content is about and helps reduce bounce rate. Don't have duplicated content. Add a sitemap to your website. Don't have broken links on your website. Make sure your website is as fast as possible. Google ranks websites higher for having HTTPS/SSL websites. Some web hosts offer this for free. Step 6, publishing content. We have a lot of articles about creating content. I would say 80% of getting traffic to your website is about creating the best content possible. Examples of content you can create: how-to guides, interviews, top lists, videos, podcasts. Our biggest tips for making sure your content brings lots of people to your site is: do keyword research. If you choose keywords that no one is searching for, then you shouldn't expect people to find your articles. Keyword research. Above you can see a screenshot from Ahrefs. Using this post as an example, I searched for how to create a website. You can see in the top right corner that it gets 119,000 searches a month. That's a lot of traffic. Perhaps too much traffic, because the more traffic a search term gets, usually means the harder it is to rank for. On the left side you can see that I will need 259 websites to link to this article to rank in the top 10. Now this is a lot because it's a very competitive search term, but it's not impossible. Getting backlinks is mainly down to creating great content. If you can create better content than anyone else that ranks for the same search term, then you have a good chance of ranking high in Google. Step 7, monetizing your website. In our experience, the best way to monetize a website is to create and sell your own products. However, when you first start your website, this is often not possible because you need to spend most of your time creating content. What I would suggest to anyone with a new website is, build an email list and focus on monetizing your website with affiliate links. An email list lets you collect emails from readers so that you can email them later. Affiliate marketing is when you promote someone's product and receive a commission when people buy through your link. To get a good idea of all the different ways to monetize a website, check out this guide for making money online. Articles to help you create your website. Now you have set up your website, it's time to learn and implement the things that will drive traffic to your website and make you money. Publishing content that drives traffic. Content is why someone visits your website. Creating great content will mean more people will visit your website. Would you still be reading this website if it wasn't for the great content? No. Write well and people will come. How I get over 100,000 visitors a month with top list articles. 7 lessons from 50 blog posts that send me the most traffic. 10 article headline examples that got us 10 million readers. How to write a blog post that gets incredible results. How to get people to visit your website. What is the point of creating a website if no one visits it apart from yourself and a few close friends? I have published some great posts about how to drive traffic to your blog. Without traffic, you can't make money. Without great content, people won't stay long enough to earn you money. Do you see how this is all coming together? My top 3 blog traffic secrets. Fastest way to get 1,000 visitors per day. 10 best WordPress plugins for getting more traffic to your website. The beginner's guide to seeing massive Pinterest traffic. How to drive traffic from Facebook fan pages. How to make money from your website. I create websites because it's my passion, but I don't think I would enjoy it as much if I didn't make so much money from it. Here are my favorite articles that I wrote related to making money from the website. 14 ways to actually make money from the website. 9 set and forget ways to increase sales on your website. The 5 best ways to grow your email list fast. 10 ways to increase your affiliate sales. How to make your website even better. I'm a perfectionist and I know every improvement I make is going to mean more traffic to my website, which in turn will make me even more money. Here are some posts to help you make improvements. 18 website optimization tips for more traffic and higher conversions. 13 expert level blog design tips for beginners. 24 rules I follow in creating successful websites. 16 ways to speed up your WordPress website today. Blog posts to inspire you to work harder. We all struggle to keep motivated. Personally, I'm at the point with my business where I don't have any financial worries, so it's hard for me to find a reason to keep working, because to be honest with you, I don't. I do. However, because I'm motivated by success, you may be the same, or you may not be making money yet and want to get to this point. Here are my favorite posts to inspire and motivate you to keep pushing forward. Top earning blogs, how much money the top blogs earn. 20 blogs that sold for millions. The 20 biggest benefits of blogging. 20 bloggers who became famous, and so much more.